This whole provision around emails applies to a number of them.
I call Jamie Lee Ross. I call Gareth Hughes.
Kia ora, Madam Chair. Ngā mihi nui kia koutou. Kia ora. I rise to support this legislation. Look, it's an admirable effort this Parliament's doing to modernise our communications legislation. 17 government departments are covered by this legislation. Now, I want to confine my comments to the copyright provisions in Part 3 of this legislation, because it's something I've got a bit of experience with in this House, with the Copyright Infringing File Sharing Act. We've got the Copyright Review going through at the moment. Now, there's a few key questions that arise out of this legislation. Now, it's admirable this Parliament is trying to clarify how email communication can be used, because when it comes to copyright, you've got basically two sides of the debate, or two sides of the relationship. So a copyright owner has to notice that their copyright has been infringed and then send a notice to the relevant agencies. And then the appropriate mechanisms are invoked under the Copyright Act 1996. So in Part 3, what we see is that, and by amending Section 136A of the existing Copyright Act, the Chief Executive may suspend notice. Now, I want to read this out because it's kind of quite tricky language. In the absence of proof to the contrary, written advice that is emailed to a person must be treated as received by the person on the second working day after the date on which it is emailed. And in providing that the advice was emailed, it is sufficient to prove that the advice was properly addressed and sent to the email address. Now, if memory serves me correct, the existing older legislation had a 20 working day period. My question for the Minister is, it's correct that we're allowing emails as a valid form of formal communications, and here you've got 2 days to consider it read. But what happens when it goes to the spam filter? Now, I bet every member in this House has spent more than 2 days replying to a constituent's email, an email from your party. Now, I'm embarrassed to say that I'm in that category, taking far too long to reply. Is 2 days the appropriate mechanism? What does happen in the case of a spam filter? Where would you go? Where is the appropriate agency to, to have it considered if it's appropriate or not? And I guess it's more on the a different side, but when down at new clause 53, amending section 139 of the Copyright Act, it's basically clarifying around fax numbers. Now, far from me to tell the government legislation, is it appropriate to be modernising legislation by including references to fax in 2017? I remember when I first entered Parliament nearly 8 years ago, the fax number was assiduously printed on the bottom of my business card. I wouldn't even know where the fax machine is in my office, Madam Chair. So while we're doing the modernisation project of legislation, should we be including... if there's any statistics on how many fax machines are still operational in New Zealand, that would be useful. Because what we are talking about with the Copyright Act is severe penalties, including financial and criminal. When it comes to the provisions which haven't been enacted by the government, we've actually got the powers under the Copyright Infringing File Sharing Act to terminate internet customers' internet access. Now, I think that's an egregious step that goes far beyond the bounds, but when it recounts on sending notices, a warning detection notice, via email, we need to make sure that those people, I think there's been about 13 or maybe 17 cases under that existing legislation, popularly known as the Skynet Act, that have been applied. In some cases, we've actually seen people serving in the New Zealand Defence Forces overseas served with these detection notices. So it's important as we modernise our legislation, the way government departments interact between each other and with New Zealand citizens, that we've got the appropriate rules in place to deal with these important questions. Kia ora koutou.
Madam Chair.
The Honourable Tracy Watkins.
No, Tracy Martin.
Oh, Tracy.
That's all right. Thank you, Madam Chair.